There's a lot of scenes in there that have been my life or things that I've seen or experienced. In 2015, my dad passed. I think a lot of the play explores dealing with grief. That really got me motivated to talk about something that really personal to me. I wanted to challenge myself, tell a story that other people had connected with. I think that's around the same time as well, a boy from my hometown died tragically. The circumstances caused a great racial divide in the town. I wanted to explore a bit of that as well.
It's really a story that touches home with me, and I think the story touches home with kind of a lot of Indigenous people. Black theatre has always been this kind of this vehicle for political change, or to have a voice, a kind of unedited voice. And I think that's exactly how Mayne's utilising theatre, and probably one of the reasons behind why he does theatre.
It's an important story in terms of this is now and this is happening. I think there's always a good thing when new works come through, and especially when you're speaking of like my particular generation. I think there's a number of artists at the moment that we've all got companion pieces all going at the same time. Whether our voices are similar or not, you're starting to hear that those kids that grew up in the 90s and, you know, late 80s, and when people see their selves or their similar upbringing or something like that, I think it's great to represent people of now and things that connect with you.